digestion, man.
You stop being embarrassed because you asked for breakfast. That's nothing.
I never done it before.
What's the difference? You probably never had cherry pie for breakfast before.
That's right, ma'am. I didn't.
You're going to be awfully hot working in that jacket.
My shirt's awful dirty, ma'am.
Well, I'll wash it for you while you bring in the trash.
I sure would like to feel clean. Won't anybody object?
Of course not. You're a man. What's the difference?
Reserve a table at City Hall. and tell him to get one down by the river close to a dutch oven. He'll think I'm being bossy. Alan doesn't mind if a woman's bossy.
Whenever I hear that train coming into town, I always get a feeling of excitement in here.
Whenever I hear it, I tell myself, someday I'm going to get on that train and I'm going to New York.
That train only goes as far as Tulsa.
Tulsa, that's another train.
I always wonder, maybe some wonderful person is getting out here, just by accident. And he'll come into the dime store for something, and he'll see me behind the counter. And he'll study me very strangely, and then decide I'm just the person you're looking for in Washington for an important job in the espionage department. Or maybe he wants me for some great medical experiment.
Things like that don't happen in dime stores.
Bad.
Millie, would you take the milk in, please? Did you and Alan have a good time on your date last night?
Uh-huh.
What did you do?
I drove over to his house, and he played some classical records.
Then what did you do?
Drove over to Cherry Bell and had some barbecue.
Matt, does Alan ever make love?
When you drive over to Cherry Bell, we always park the car by the river and feel the land.
Did you let him kiss you? After all, you've been going together all summer.
Of course. I let him.
Does he ever want to go beyond kissing?
Mom!
I'm your mother, for heaven's sake. He says that's what he's talking about, does he?
Well, yes.
Does Alan get mad if you won't?
No.
He does.
He doesn't get mad.
Well, do you like it when he kisses you?
Yes.
You don't sound very enthusiastic.
What do you expect me to do? Pass out every time Alan puts his arm around?
No, you don't have to pass out, but it seems to me you could at least...
What?
Hold this dress up in front. Man, it'd be awfully nice to be married to Alan. You'd have charge accounts at all the stores, automobiles, trips. You'd be invited by all his friends to parties at their homes and at the country club.
Mom, I don't feel right with those people.
What do you mean? You're just as good as they are. My father was in the state legislature. My mother's family was one of the...
I don't know, Mom. All Alan's friends talk about colleges and trips to Europe.
Well, I feel left out. You just have to get over those people. Now, Alan will be going back to school in a few weeks. There won't be many more opportunities like the picnic tonight. You better get busy. Matt, a pretty girl doesn't have long. Just a few years when she's the equal of Kate. We can walk out of a shanty like this and live in a palace where the doting husband will spend his life making her happy.
I suppose.
Because once she is young and pretty. If she loses that chance, she might just as well throw all the prettiness away.
I'm only 18.
And next summer you'll be 19, and then 20, and then 21, and then 40.
Everyone around here gets to dress up and go places except me.
Alan said he'd try to find you a date for the picnic tonight.
I don't want Alan asking any of these crazy boys in town to take me anywhere.
Beggars can't be choosers.
Shut up!
Man, that was me. They'll be dancing at the pavilion tonight. Millie should have a date too.
If she wants a date, why doesn't she dress up and act decent?
Because I'm going to dress and act the way I want to, and if you don't like it, you know it.
Because she doesn't have any friends, but she smells so bad, people don't want to be near her.
Madge. Madge is the pretty one. She's so dumb, they almost had to burn the schoolhouse down to get her out of it. Oh, isn't it? You never would have graduated if it hadn't been for Jumpin' Jeter.
Who's Jumpin' Jeter?
Teaches history. Kids call him Jumpin' Jeter because the pretty girls in his classes make him so jumpy. He was punking Madge till she went in his room and cried. I just don't know what I'll do if I don't pass history.
Mom, you're making that up.
Like fun I am. You couldn't even pass Miss Cindy's course in shorthand. And you have to work in the dime store.
You are a goof.
Madge.
Madge, you slut. You take that back or I'll kill you.
Girl, stop it. What will the neighbors say?
Nobody's gonna call me a goon and get by with it.
You called her worse names.
Doesn't hurt what names I
scholarship to 4 whole years of college.
A girl like Millie can need confidence in other ways.
Mom?
Yes.
Do you love Millie more than me?
Of course not.
Then why do you act as if you did?
Madge, listen to me. You were the firstborn. Your father thought the sun rose instead of you. He used to carry you on his shoulder for the neighborhood to see. When Millie came, things were different. How? They were just different. Your father wasn't home much of the time then. The night Millie was born, he was with a bunch of his wild friends at the roadhouse.
Was he sorry?
Yes, he was always sorry. And I always forgave him.
Anyway, you loved him.
Well, what if I did? It takes a lot more than love to keep people happy.
Mom?
Yes.
What good is it to be pretty?
Well, pretty things are rare in this life.
But what good are they?
Well, pretty things like flowers and sunsets and rubies and pretty girls can. They're like billboards telling us that life's good.
But where do I come in?
What do you mean?
Maybe I get tired of being looked at.
Madge, don't talk selfish.
I don't care if I am selfish. It's no good just to be pretty. It's no good.
Ma'am! Is it alright if I start a fire?
What?
The nice lady said it's hot enough there already and maybe you object, so how about it, ma'am? Mind a little fire?
No, I don't mind.
I didn't think you would.
It's got no shame. He just moves right in whether you want to or not.
I knew you wouldn't like him when I first saw him.
Do you?
I don't like him or dislike him. I just wonder what he's like.
I know what he's like.
Anyone mind if an old maid school teacher joins their company?
Come sit down, Rosemary.
Mail come yet?
Well, there's no mail today. It's Labor Day.
Oh, I forgot. I thought I might be getting a letter from a man I met at the high school picnic last spring. Been wanting to marry me ever since.
A nice fella. I don't have time for any of them when they start getting serious on me.
Your school teachers are mighty independent.
Oh, shoot. I've lived this long without a man. I hope you can keep me from getting on without one.
Well, what about Howard?
Howard?
He's just a friend boy, not a boyfriend.
I smell smoke.
Helen Potts is having her leaves burned. Smells kind of good, don't you think?
Who's the young man?
Just another no-good Helen Potts took you.
Good Lord, Mrs. Owens. He is working over there naked as an Indian. That's right in the presence of ladies.
Millie, get back here.
Gee whiz, I go swimming every day and the boys don't have on half as much as he does now.
Swimming's different.
Matt.
What?
Can I use your manicure set? Just for kicks.
You promise not to get it messy?
Look at the way he's showing them all.
Who does he think is interesting?
What's that you're rubbing in?
Oh, Fonsella, three-way tissue cream. Makes a good base for your makeup.
There was an article in the Reader's Digest about some woman who got skin poisoning from using all those face creams.
Harriet Bristol, she's the American history teacher. She got a hold of some of that beauty clay last winter. Dirty took her skin off. All we girls thought she had leprosy.
Man, how do you do your right hand?
You were nice to people, maybe people would do something nice for you.
You got a bow, Millie?
No.
You can't kid me. Girls don't paint their fingernails without a reason.
Madge, will you try this dress on out here?
Hello?
Who?
Are you going to be using the clothesline this morning?
No.
Hi.
Hi, Alan! Oh boy, I'm gonna get my soup!
Sydney.
Hello.
Hello, Alan.
Hello.
Have you girls seen the handsome young man I have working for me?
Handsome.
Ellen Potts, I wish you'd stop taking in all sorts of riffraff.
He's not riffraff. He's been to several colleges.
Oh. And he begs for breakfast.
He's working for his breakfast. And Alan, he said he knew you at university. I told him he might be by.
Hey, Alan. We going swimming?
You bet.
Why don't you go and see Matt? Just fall from the bottom of the stairs.
Okay.
Millie.
Hey! Delilah!
Do you think Alan is going to marry Madge?
I hadn't thought much about it.
It's so hot and still this time of year. I guess like this, I'd welcome a good cyclone. Even if it blew everything away.
I'd rather wipe my brow than get blown away.
Look at him lift that washcloth. So much tissue paper.
Poking at things with swords. Touché, bud.
It was real crazy.
Well, did they give you any lines to read?
Yeah, that part went okay. It was my teeth.
Your teeth?
Yeah, out there, you gotta have a certain kind of teeth, or they just can't use you. Don't ask me why. This babe said they'd have to pull all my teeth and give me new ones, so naturally.
Wait a minute, what babe?
The babe that got me the screen test.
She wasn't a babe, exactly. She was kind of beat up, but not bad.
Jesus. Seymour, a guy's gotta get along somehow.
Uh-huh. What are you doing here?
I came to see you.
Yeah?
Well, you see, after Hollywood, I took a job on a ranch in Nevada. Seymour, you would have been proud of me. In bed every night at 10. Up every morning at 6. No liquor, no babes. I saved $200.
Oh, you came to pay me back.
Well, Seymour, I was gonna, but I got rolled.
Rolled? You?
Yeah, by two babes. See, I was gonna hitchhike down to Texas to try my luck. I got as far as Phoenix when two babes pull up in this big yellow convertible, and this one babe slams on the brakes and hollers, "Get in, stud!" So I got in, Seymour. It was crazy. There was a shaker full of martinis right there in the car.
Are you two boys talking over old times? Millie, help me, I should
pay. Any more work, ma'am?
Oh no, I feel very well paid for breakfast.
Suppose there's a place I could wash up.
We got a shower in the basement. Come on, I'll show you.
He'll be there in a minute. So, we got a shaker full of martinis right in the car.
This game is smoking weed.
Nothing like that ever happens to me.
Boring story. Seymour, you wouldn't believe it. The things these two babes started doing to me.
Were they good looking?
What do you care?
Makes the story more interesting. Tell me what you did exactly.
Well, you know me, Seymour. I'm an agreeable guy.
Sure.
So, when they parked in front of the tourist cabin, I said, "Okay, girls, if I gotta pay for the ride, this is the easiest way I know." But Seymour, they must have thought I was Superman.
You mean both of them?
Sure.
Golly!
But then I said, "Okay, girls, party's over. Let's get going." And then the dame on the weed, she sticks a gun in my back, and she says, "This party's going till we say it's over, Buck." You would have thought she was Humphrey Bogart. What happened? Finally, I passed out. And when I woke up, the dames were gone, and so was my $200. I went to the police, they wouldn't believe me. They said my story was wishful thinking. I'm telling you, Seymour, women are getting desperate.
Are they?
Well, that did it. Then I thought, what's a poor bastard like me ever gonna do?
Well, you don't sound to me like you'd had such a bad life.
Then I got to thinking about you, Seymour, at school, the way you always have things under control.
Me?
Yeah, you never cut classes, understood lectures, never missed. You took notes? What's so funny?
Well, the one authentic hero the university had, he envied me.
Yeah, big hero, but just between the goalposts. Seymour, you're the only guy in the whole fraternity that ever treated me like a human being.
I know.
Those are the phonies always watching to see what fork I use.
You just imagine that.
In a pig's eye, I think.
Why do you feel you're any worse than everybody else?
Well, maybe I'll tell you something
then. Your father drinks. So what? It happens in the best of families.
He died in jail. Seymour, blasted and scraped him over the sidewalk.
Gee, pal, I'm awfully sorry to hear that.
The old lady wouldn't even come across with the dough for the funeral. They had to bury him in Papa's robe.
But what about the filling station?
Oh, he left it to me as well. But the old lady wanted it so bad, she was going to have him declared insane. So I let her have it. Who needs it?
Now, I can't believe people really do things like that.
Don't let my story cloud up with rose glasses.
Why didn't you come to see me when you got to town?
I didn't want to walk into your palatial mansion looking like a bum. I wanted to pick up some change, buy a new shirt.
Would it make any difference?
Well, I was hoping maybe you and your old man, when you could fix me up with a job.
Well, what kind of job, pal?
What kind of jobs you got?
What do you have in mind?
Something in a nice office where I can wear a tie and have a sweet little secretary and talk over the telephone about enterprises and things. Seymour, I always thought if I had the chance, I could set the whole world on fire.
Lots of guys have that feeling.
I gotta get some place in this world, Seymour. I got to.
Take it easy.
This is a free country, and I got as much rights as the next fellow. Why can't I get along?
Don't worry, pal. I will help you out as much as I can. Sinclair is hiring new men, aren't they, Mrs. Potts?
Yes, Alan. Carrie wants 100 men for the pipeline.
How about the pipeline, Hal?
Great. Great. Where's that shower?
Isn't he a nice young man?
It's a private party I'm crashing?
Ooh, mine, you're dressed up.
It's my new fall outfit. I got it in Kansas City. Paid $22.50 for the hat.
You school teachers do have nice things.
And we don't have to ask anybody when we want to get them either.
You'll be here for lunch today, Rosemary?
No, there's a welcome home party down at the hotel, lunch and bridge for the new girls on the faculty.
Can I go swimming?
No, who
makes
lunch? I've got a million things to do.
It wouldn't kill Millie if she ever did any cooking.
No, but it might kill the rest of her.
Every time he came into a room, the other fellas seemed to bristle. I didn't like him either at first, and then we shared a room and I got to know him better. Hal is really a nice guy. That's the best friend I ever had.
Is he wild?
Oh, not really. He just... Mrs. Owens, would you like to withdraw your invitation?
No! No, Alan, not if you... Does he drink?
A little. Mrs. Owens, Hal pays attention to me. I will see that he behaves.
I wouldn't want anything to happen to Millie.
Oh.
Mom.
Millie can take care of herself.
Oh, maybe you're right. Oh, dear. Come on, Helen. Oh, why can't things be simple?
Fixing drinks?
Oh, of course he was. He's always very nice to me. Very polite. He explained how sorry he was he had to go away.
Are you sorry?
Of course. There'll be lots of pretty girls in college.
Honestly, Madge, my entire 4 years, I never found a girl I liked.
I don't believe that.
It's true. They're all so affected. You wanted a date with them, yet... Call him a month in advance. Madge, it's sort of hard for me to say this, but I honestly never believed a girl like you could care for me.
Alan.
I hope you do care for me, Madge.
Hey, Seymour.
What's the matter, Hal? Can't stand to see anybody else kiss a pretty girl?
What the hell, Seymour?
Hal! Will you watch your language?
Oh, Hal.
I'm sorry.
It's all right.
What's the trouble?
Look, Seymour,
I've never been on a picnic. What are you talking about? Everybody's been on a picnic.
Not me. I was too busy shooting crabs or stealing milk bottles.
Well, there's a first time for everything.
I wasn't brought up talking like you. I won't know how to act around these women.
Women aren't anything new in your life.
Seymour, these are nice women. What if I send them all work? What if my stomach
You're
drops?
A psycho. Run along. I'll see you in a minute.
Hey, hurry it up, will you?
I'll see you tonight, Madge.
All right, Alan.
Madge, maybe after supper, you and I can get away from the others and take a boat out on the river.
All right, Alan.
See if you look real in the moonlight.
Alan, don't say that.
Why? I don't care if you're real or not. You are the most beautiful thing I ever saw.
Just the same.
I had to bathe, dust my limbs with powder, and
slip into my frock.
Did you clean up the bathtub?
Yes, I cleaned up the bathtub. Madge, how do I look? Now tell the truth.
You look very pretty.
Feels sort of funny.
You can have it if you want it.
Thanks. Madge, how do you talk to boys?
Why, just talk to them, silly.
How do you think of things to say?
I don't know. You just say whatever comes into your head.
Supposing nothing ever comes into my head.
You were talking with them all right this morning.
I've had a date with him, and it's different.
You're crazy.
I think he's a big show-off. You should have seen him this morning on the high diving board. He did real graceful swan dives, and a 2.5 gainer, and a backflip. The kids stood around, clapping. He just ate it up.
I think I'll paint my toenails tonight for salmon.
He was bragging all afternoon how he used to be a deep-sea diver off Catalina Island.
Honest?
And he says he used to make hundreds of dollars doing parachute jumps out of a balloon. Do you believe it?
I don't see why not.
You never hear Alan bragging that way.
Alan never jumped out of a balloon.
Madge, I think he's girl crazy too.
You think every boy you see is something horrible.
Alan took us to the High Hope for Cokes, and there was a gang of girls in the back booth, Juanita Badger and her gang. When they saw him, they started giggling and tee-heeing and saying all sorts of crazy things. Then Juanita Badger comes up to me and whispers, "I think he's the cutest thing I ever saw." Is he, Madge?
I wouldn't say he's the cutest thing I ever saw.
Juanita Badger's a little floozy. She sits in the back row at the movies, so the boys would come in and we'll see her and sit with her. One time, she and Rubberneck Krause were asked by the management to leave. They weren't just kissing, either.
Oh! I never even speak to Juanita Badger.
Madge, do you think he'll like me?
If you give him a chance, he will.
I don't really care. I just wonder.
Why ask me all the questions? You're supposed to be the smart one.
Not when it comes to boys. I'm absolutely ignorant.
Oh, now I tell myself I've got two beautiful daughters.
Be quiet, Mom.
Doesn't Melly look pretty, Madge?
When she isn't picking your nose.
Madge. She doesn't want anyone to be pretty but her.
You're just saying I'm pretty because you're my mom.
Does that keep it from being true? Run over, show Helen Potts how nice you look.
Here comes Millie Owens, the great beauty of all times. Be prepared to swoon.
Girl, I want to tell you, one after pretty soon.
Mom, is there any hot water?
You'll have to go up and see, Dar.
Miss Sydney, would you mind terribly if I used some of your shower alarm?
Help yourself.
Thanks.
Oh. Mad thinks too much about the boys, Miss Sylvia.
It's a miracle. That's what it is. I never knew that Millie could look so pretty. It's like this movie I saw once with Betty Grable. What was it, Madam Turner? Anyway, she played the part of a secretary to some very important businessman. And she wore glasses and she did her hair real plain. And the men didn't pay any notice to her at all. And then one day she took off her glasses. And the boss wanted to marry her right away. Now I tell Millie all the boys are going to be falling in love with her.
You got a date tonight, Millie?
Yes, I'm sorry to say.
What?
Who is he? Tell your Aunt Rosemary.
How?
Who?
The young man over at Helen's turned out to be a friend of Alan's.
Oh, him?
Helen, have you gone to the trouble of baking another cake?
Well, an old lady like me, she wants any attention from the young men at the picnic. All she can do is make a cake. Look, I feel sort of excited. I think that we plan picnics just to give ourselves an excuse for something thrilling and romantic to happen to us.
Such as what?
I don't know. That's what's so exciting.
Oh, Millie makes me furious. Every time she takes a bath, she fills up the whole bathtub. Now there isn't any hot water.
You should have thought of it earlier.
It's him!
Oh, it's Howard. Hello, Howard.
If he's been drinking, I'm not going out with him.
Hi, ladies.
Miss Owens.
Hello, Howard.
You sure look pretty, Rosemary.
Seems to me you might have left your coat on.
Still too darn hot, even if it is September. Good evening, Madge.
Hi, Howard.
How are things over in Cherryvale, Howard?
Good business. Back to school and everybody's fine.
Your business is good. It's good for everyone.
Hi, Howard.
Hey. Millie's a good-looking kid. I never realized it before.
Mom, what time did fellas need to be here?
5:30. You've asked me a dozen times. There's Alan. Oh, he's brought both cars.
One of these days, you'll be riding around in that big Cadillac mini boat.
Everybody ready?
Come sit down, Alan.
The more the merrier.
Yeah, I brought both cars. Hal's parking the Ford. The trunk and the Cadillac won't hold everything, so whatever's left over, Hal and Emily can drive out in the Ford. Ain't beautiful? Hal!
Is he a careful driver, Hal?
Hey, Seymour.
Look, Seymour, I'm a big man. I'm a lot huskier than you are. I can't wear your jacket.
Can I take it off?
Yes.
I never could wear another fellow's clothes. See, I'm kind of beefy through the shoulders. I should have all my clothes tailored me. Hercules, I think you've met Mrs. Owens.
Oh, she's the mother.
And I believe you met Mrs. Potts this morning.
She's my best girl.
I begged Lady Baltimore Kate.
This little lady, she took pity on me when I was practically starving. See, I ran into some hard luck on my way over here. Some character brought me a nervous scent I had. You see these characters?
And, this is Rosemary Sydney, Hal. Miss Sydney teaches shorthand and typing in the local high school.
Yes, I'm an old maid school teacher.
I have every respect for school teachers, ma'am. It's a lot of hard work and not much pay.
And this is Howard Bevins, Hal. Mr. Bevins is a friend of Miss Sydney.
I run a little shop over in Cherryvale, don't you?
Novelties and school supplies. You and Alan drive over sometime. Get acquainted.
We'll be over as soon as we can fit in our schedules. Hey, kid. Wow. You got a little more tan today, didn't you? You folks should have seen Millie at the pool this morning. She did a fine jackknife off that high diving board.
Hey, now.
What's the matter, kid? You think I'm snowing you under? I wouldn't admit this to many people, but she does a jackknife almost as good as me. And I was diving champion on the West Coast, so I know what I'm talking about.
Matt, you should be getting dressed.
Go on upstairs and get beautiful for us.
Mom, can I wear my new dress?
No, I made that dress to whoever dances this fall. Go on,
Dad. Wait a minute.
Where'd you get those boots?
I guess I ought to apologize for the way I look, but you see those characters I was telling you about, they made off with my clothes too, and I went to the police.
What a pity!
You see, the
the reason I brought the subject up was I just didn't want folks to think you were associating with a bum. So, what the hell's the use?
Clothes don't make the man.
Helen, is your mother taken care of?
Yes, Flo, I have a babysitter for her.
Come on, let's start packing the basket.
See, ma'am, my old man left me these boots when he died.
That's all he left you, just a pair of boots?
He gave me these boots, and he said, son, the man of the house needs a pair of boots because he's got to do a lot of kicking. And he made up a little poem. Your wages are all spent, the landlord wants his rent, you go to your woman for solace, and she fills you full of torment. He says, son, there'll be times when the only thing you got to be proud of is the fact that you're a man. So you wear your boots and people can hear you coming. And you keep your fists doubled up so they know you mean business when you get there. My old man, he was a courser.
Hal is always so shy of people before he meets them. And then he can't keep still.
Yeah. Hi.
Hi.
What line of business are you in, son?
Sir, I'm about to enter the oil business.
Oh.
You see, while my old man was no aristocratic millionaire or anything, he did have some very important friends who were very big men in their own way. One of them wanted me to take a position on his oil company down in Texas.
Dad and I have found a place for Hal on the pipeline.
Gee, Seymour, I think you ought to let me tell the story.
Well, after all, Hal, these people aren't interested in your life history.
Yeah. So, I decided starting from the very bottom. There are more important things in life than money. I guess I learned that much. But I certainly do appreciate this opportunity, and it's all due to Seymour and his old father.
I think that's wonderful.
It's a good business town. A young man can go far.
Sir, I intend to go far.
A young man just coming to town has got to be a good mixer. Mm.
Well, wouldn't it be nice if he could join the country club and play golf?
He won't be able to afford that.
The bowling team's a rowdy gang.
And there's the young men's Bible class at Baptist Church.
Dad, are you still here?
Everyone will pardon me, Uncle. It's a night time.
Yeah, hurry it up, will you, Delilah?
He ought to see you in the ashrooms. She's about 6 times the face of me and dusts herself all over the cover. And her perfume under the ears to make her feel mysterious. Takes her half an hour. She won't be ready for hours.
Come on, Helen. Alan, we're going to need a man to chip the ice and put the baskets in the car.
I'll help you, ma'am.
No, thank you. Alan, if you don't mind.
Mind your manners, Hal.
Mom?
Why don't we show the young man your drawings?
Want to see my art?
You mean to tell me you can draw pictures?
That's Mrs. Potts.
Looks just like her.
I just love Mrs. Potts. When I go to heaven, I expect everyone to be just like her.
Hey, kid, you want to draw me?
Well, I'll try.
I had a job as a model once. They made me pose raw in front of the whole class. How's this? It's okay, I got plenty more. Okay? That's hard.
Howard, look at that sunset.
Pretty, isn't it?
That's the most flaming sunset I ever did see.
If you painted that in a picture, no one would believe you.
It's like the daylight didn't want to end, isn't it?
Oh, I don't know.
It's like the daytime was going to put up a big scrap and maybe set the world on fire just to keep nighttime creeping on.
Uh-huh. I think I see what you mean there, huh?
You know, there comes a time in a guy's life where he's got to settle down. Quit rolling around like a pinball.
No, Howard! If Millie's going to be here, I don't think there ought to be any drinking.
What's that?
Nothing.
Hey, kid. What'd you do this afternoon?
Read a book.
You read a whole book in one afternoon?
Sure. Hold still.
Well, I'm a son of a gun. What was it about?
Well, it's kind of hard to explain. Just the way you feel when you read it. Kind of warm inside and sad and amused. All at the same time.
Yeah, sure. I used to go with a girl who read books. She joined the Book of the Month Club and had her reading books all the time. She wouldn't any more than finish one book and they'd send her another one.
Where are you going, Howard?
I'll be right back, honey.
Not bad. I sure do admire people who are artistic. Can I keep it?
Sure. I write poetry, too. I've written poems I've never shown to a living soul.
No kidding.
Howard! Leave that bottle right where it is!
Did you say bottle?
Oh, he has been down to the hotel buying bootleg whiskey off those good-for-nothing porters.
Yeah, man, maybe you'd like a swig of this.
Hot dinner! Put that away!
Oh, Lily's not gonna be shocked if she sees someone take a drink, are you, Billy?
Gosh, no.
What if someone come by and tell the school board I would lose my job quick as you can say Jack Robinson?
Who's gonna see, honey? Everybody in town's at the picnic.
I don't care! Liquor is against the law in this state, and a person ought to abide by the law. Isn't that what you say, young fella?
Sure, a person ought to abide by the law.
Here, honey.
No, Cal, I am not going to touch a drop.
One little drink won't hurt you.
I said no, and I mean no.
Come on, honey, have one little drink. Just
murder.
You want to be ashamed of
yourself. Well, I guess I know why you want me to take a drink.
Oh, honey, that is not so. I just think you should have a good time like the rest of us. School teachers got a right to live, right?
Right!
Now, Billy, don't you tell any of the kids at school.
We take
you for it. Anyone coming?
No, this is clear.
Ouch! Oh, I want water.
Another girl, go in the house and get her some.
No, Howard, I'll get a drink from the hydrant.
Another my girl, I'd like to offer you one, but I'm afraid your old lady and raised dead.
What mom don't know won't hurt her.
Hey, you lay off the stuff.
Howard, come help me, I see a snake.
You go, Millie, she don't see no snake.
Freak out.
Look at her there.
How in her arms.
I was in love with a pretty girl like her once. You know, every time I come over here, I look forward just to seeing her.
I tell myself, Bevan's a little boy, you can look at that all you want, but you couldn't touch it with a 10-foot pole.
Oh, I sure am glad Seymour found such a great babe because he's my friend.
Oh, Seymour's a young pup. He'll go off to school soon and forget all about her.
I don't see how anyone could forget her.
Look at her. Putting lipstick on that cute kisser.
They tell me every boy in town's been on the make for that since she was old enough to go to Sunday school.
Seems to me when the good Lord made a girl as pretty as she is, he did it for a reason.
It's about time she found out what that reason is.
Look, son, if you're agonizing, I know a couple of girls down at the hotel.
Thanks a lot, but you see, I never had to pay for it.
I think that's a very fine attitude.
I was gonna faint.
It was just a piece of garden hose.
What have you two been talking about?
I'm talking about better, honey.
I've been.
Were, honey.
Did my mother ever caught me showing off in front of a window and didn't tan me with a razor strap?
Of course, honey.
No, because he was a God-fearing man.
Listen, Miss Sydney. It's Ernie Higgins in his happiest voice. Hey, hit it, Ernie!
Lord. Oh, I love that music. Come dance with me.
Ow, honey, I'm not ready to dance.
Oh, that's just what you meant, folks. Tell yourself to get out of it. Come dance with me,
Billy. I gotta leave.
Both Hal and I did that.
Go ahead, for all I care.
Woo!
Thank you.
fun to have with me.
Am I too bad?
Nah, you just need a little practice.
Oh, Lord! I love to dance!
At school, kids all call me the dancing fool. I went dancing somewhere every night.
I can't stay inside while they're dancing.
Now look, kid, you gotta remember, I'm the man. You gotta do the steps I do.
I keep wanting to do the steps and make it myself.
A man's gotta lead, kid, as long as he's able to.
You're
doing great, kid.
One night I went dancing at a big Valentine party. I danced so hard, I swooned. That's when they called me the dancing fool.
Hey, I'll show you a new step, kid. I learned this in LA. Try it.
I got on boots.
Let's get a man alone.
He's dead for that.
Well, now it is his turn.
dance with me. I may be an old maid school teacher, but I believe in you. I met him in Colorado when I went out there to get over a case of the flu. He was in love with me because I was an older woman and had some sense. He took me up to the mountains one night and made love. He wanted me to marry him right there on the mountaintop. Say, gods be our preacher and the moon of best man. Did you ever hear such talk? Did you? Hey, where are you going?
You gotta dance with me.
Ma'am, I guess I just don't feel like dancing.
I can keep up with you!
Rose, hurry! He's dancing with Madge! They're young people!
Young? What do you mean they're young?
I'm sick! Really? I wanna die!
What the little Dickens do? Get herself tight?
Take it easy, kiss!
Rose, that's so wonderful! They're young!
They hate you!
Really?
Madge is a pretty one! Madge is a pretty one!
Mom's gonna be furious.
She must have had herself several good snifters. It's all his fault, Howard!
Oh, Millie was your date. You were supposed to be looking after her, but you were busy making eyes at me. And you're no better than he is, Madge. You ought to be ashamed.
Miss Sydney,
who's that whiskey to my minute?
He did! Mrs. Owens, it's all his fault!
Mother, that is not so.
Mother, that is too young to be drinking whiskey!
Oh, he'd have fed her whiskey and taken his pleasure with the child and then ski that.
Look, everyone, listen.
I know what I'm doing, Howard.
You've been stomping around here in those boots like you own the place, thinking every woman you saw was gonna fall madly in love. Well, here's one woman who didn't pay you any money.
Aristocratic millionaire by foot. You wouldn't know an aristocratic millionaire if he spit on you. You're just a piece of Arkansas white trash.
And bragging about your father. I bet you're doing better than he is.
I bet you lose that job before your 2 weeks is up.
None of us old men are drinking.
You think just because you're young, you can push the old folks aside? Well, you'll end your life in the gutter, and it'll serve you right. Because the gutter is where you came from, and the gutter is where you belong.
Mary, shut your damn mouth.
Millie's going to be perfectly all right. Though Alan held her head so she could be sick, and she's going to be perfectly all right.
I want it understood. There's to be no more drinking on this thing.
It was all my fault, Ms. Owens. My fault.
Oh, here's Billy now, good as new. And now we're all going on a picnic and forget all about it.
Hal, what happened?
Alan, Ned will come with us.
Sure, Mrs. Owens. Hal, I told you not to drink.
Ned, why did you wear your new dress?
Oh, no, I just put it on.
Well, go upstairs and change this minute I made it. You come with Rosemary and Hal.
Let's go, all the tables are going to be taken.
Mr. Bevins, tell Madge I'll see her out here. Hell, the baskets are in the Ford. Get going.
You follow us, young man. You'll find the way.
He's just a boy.
Rosemary, you talked awful.
Howard, why did I do that? Why did I act that way?
You've got to remember that men have got feelings too. Same as women.
Don't pay her any attention, young man. She didn't mean a thing.
I don't want to go on the picnic tonight, Howard. It's my last night of vacation, and I want to have a good time.
Anything you say, dear?
I want to go for a ride, Howard. I want to drive into the sunset. I want to drive into the sunset. Finally, they made the principal
I don't know how to say it, but one of the janitors got busy with a chisel, and they weren't insulted anymore. Next day there was a sign hanging on the statue, Miss Sydney was here. I know you're not in the mood for funny stories, but you really have to laugh at Miss Sydney.
What's the use, baby? She saw through me like a goddamn X-ray machine. I'm a bum. There's just no place in the world for a guy like me.
I know how you feel. Millie is so smart and talented, and I get to feel jealous of her. And worthless when I try to be like her. And then I tell myself that I'm not Millie. I'm me. And I feel lots better.
I'm me.
Sure.
Sure. But what's that?
You are very entertaining. I mean, I think you say all sorts of witty things. And you're a wonderful dancer.
What good is dance?
Oh. I can tell a lot about a boy by dancing with him.
Yeah?
Some boys might seem very smart, but they take a girl and their arms to dance. And they're kind of awkward. And she feels sort of uncomfortable.
She does?
But when you took me in your arms to dance, I had the most wonderful feeling that knew exactly where you were going. And I could follow you every step of the way. So you are not so bad. I don't care what you say.
Oh, yeah? Look, kid, let me level with you. When I was 14, I spent a year in reform school. How do you like that?
What for?
I stole a guy's motorcycle. Yeah, I stole it. I got no excuses. I stole it because I wanted to get on the goddamn thing, and I wanted to go so far away and so fast that no one would ever catch up with me.
Sure.
And then my old lady went to the authorities. I've done everything I can with the boy, she said. I can't do a thing more. So off I go to the damn reform school, and the old lady's real happy. Because Dad's always loading, and she got a new boyfriend, and I'm in the way. Well, there you are. I never told anyone about that. I didn't see me.
I wish there was something I could say or do.
Well, that's the Hal Carter story, baby, but no one's ever going to make a movie about it.
I guess most people would be awfully shocked.
So if you want to get sick or run inside and lock the door or faint, just go ahead, because I ain't stopping you. What'd you do?
I'm glad you told me.
Baby. You come out here on this porch looking like a pretty little doll, but you're a real woman, aren't you?
I want to be.
You are, baby. 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 Baby.
Don't. We have to go. We have baskets in our car.
Just be quiet, baby.
Really, we have to be going. They'll be waiting.
We ain't going to no goddamn picnic.